The chest pain that comes with a heart attack is classically described. However, what I want my patients to be aware of is nobody's supposed to read the textbook when they're having a heart attack. So while I can describe what is the textbook definition of a chest pain that is related to the heart attack, I don't want the patients to feel, okay, this is not the way that the textbook describes, so it's not a heart attack. A heart attack can be any discomfort from the jaw all the way down to the belly button, left or right, doesn't matter. But the typical textbook definition of a chest pain related to the heart attack is a feeling of pressure in the chest, mostly behind the chest bone, that comes with activity, but at times could be at rest and lasts more than 5 minutes and improves with rest or nitroglycerin. The usual presentation is associated with the discomfort radiating to the left arm or the left jaw and associated with shortness of breath. There are patients who may have some nausea and sweatiness associated with that. The discomfort doesn't relieve itself unless it's getting treated. But that's, as I said, it's a textbook definition and not necessarily what the patient may experience. I have seen many, many patients who thought their discomfort was a little lower, they thought it was indigestion and they stayed home. And when we saw them 3 days later, the only thing that they were complaining about now was shortness of breath. And the reason for that is their heart has been damaged now and is not strong anymore. So that's what I'm trying to avoid. So while I explain to you what the definition and the textbook presentation of a heart attack is, I don't expect everybody to follow the textbook definition.